Hi everybody, I'm Cameron Pittman. Welcome to this short course on JavaScript promises. Every web developer needs to be able to handle asynchronous work with confidence and ease, and that's why you're here. You're here to take advantage of native JavaScript promises. There are many methods to handle asynchronous work already. However, as you'll be discovering in this course, promises are the recommended option because they give you flexibility, intuitive syntax, and easy error handling. But before we start all that, I have an off-topic question for you. You're looking at millions of stars in the disk of our Milky Way galaxy. Every dot is a star. Some are bigger and brighter than the sun, others smaller and dimmer. But what else is in this picture? Planets. Every single star in the Milky Way is the possible home for dozens of alien worlds. That means it's likely that there are hundreds of billions of planets in our galaxy alone. The Kepler Space Observatory has found more than 1,000 exoplanets like this one in the last few years. Combined with data from other telescopes, and astronomers have confirmed sightings of almost 2,000 exoplanets. That's a lot of worlds. I had an idea when I was designing this class, and I call it the Exoplanet Explorer. It's a web app that helps people learn about real planets around other stars. Throughout this class, you'll be using promises to request real JSON data about exoplanets, and that data is coming from NASA and Caltech. You'll be using promises to turn that data into useful information in the app. Are you ready to get started?